Okay, so the music that was presented was a Ragtime episode by Paul Eno, which was a collaborative effort between the banjo and the piano. So the music evolved during the 19th century from just being played on the banjo, the Ragtime style of playing on the banjo, to the piano. So over the next half century, the black population were able to take up the piano. And really, that has a lot to do with the Emancipation Proclamations. As more slaves were emancipated, they were able to move on to bigger cities and find work and make more money. And some were even able to become a part of the quote-unquote middle class, although that meant differently for the African-Americans than the other counterparts. But they were able to make a little more money, or a lot more money, I suppose, from the days of slavery. So the piano during this time was grew in its status. The piano was an instrument that was a luxury item, and it was a symbol of middle-class gentility. And the piano was, what made the piano interesting or popular is the fact that, the piano was sturdy enough to find a home in the lower-class saloons, and we're talking about bars and social places, social establishments. And it was able to find a place in lower-class saloons on the hinge of every urban community, whether that community were white Americans or black Americans. So, how did this style, this Ragtime, as one would call it, affect the style of piano playing as the piano grew, became more popular throughout the United States? Well, the pianist, or how it translates to piano, was pretty particular. So, the style of piano Ragtime is defined by a steady two-beat rhythmic foundation in which the right hand plays a low bass notes while alternating with the higher chords. And then against this, you have the backdrop of the right hand, which was free to add contrasting rhythms, and that contradicted this two feel. I like to call it the oompa feel. Okay, so oompa, oompa. So here's somewhat of a short demonstration of that. So we have this like bass note alternating with a chord. So you hear that bass note and then chord. Okay? And so you have that going on, which kind of gives a steady beat to it. And then you also have this polyrhythmic or syncopated rhythm. It actually becomes polyrhythmic when you combine both hands, but you have this syncopated rhythm of the right hand, which creates this nice polyrhythmic sound. So here's the demonstration of a very late rag by the great William Bokum. It's called A Graceful Ghost Rag. I'm just going to play a small sample of this to just give you an idea of what we're talking about. Somewhat of a demonstration how that Ragtime translates to piano. And so I will share with you one of the most celebrated artists during this time, as Ragtime becomes Ragtime. So stay tuned for that.